So let's talk about your gal pals.
Yeah.
Your fabulous gal pals.
Ooh. My saviors.
How important are they to you?
My female friendships are, you know, in so many ways the stabilizing forces in my life. And it starts with my mom, who's probably one of my closest advisors, and I consider her my friend. But then it extends into women I've known throughout my life.
And it's so important, yet with the kids and the husband and work and life, sometimes that, how have you managed to make the, you know, those friendships and still in the, you know, craziness of the White House, make time for them?
Well, the friendships have changed based on where I was in life. So, you know, I've got the friends from college, I've got the friends from law school, but I also have the friends that I developed when I first had kids, other mothers who had kids our age. And, you know, we had a group of moms where we would get together every Saturday, starting with the kids when they were just in the little carriers. And we would have our play dates. And a lot of times those play dates, when the kids weren't moving yet, were for us.
Yeah.
You know, we just shared all those things, and those friendships continued because our girls, you know, continued to be friends. And many of those women are still the women that I count on, to kick ideas around with, to let my hair down, to vent, to laugh. But it's been so important, and I think I had to learn that because Barack traveled. I just realized having some kind of support around, whether it was my mom or a set of friends, was essential to keeping me whole and not so angry or frustrated, because I could always pick up the phone and somebody would come over with a pizza, or we'd just go and have dinner at a friend's and wouldn't have to cook, or, you know, you just share the load. And I think, you know, sometimes we as women feel like we're not doing it right unless we're doing it all ourselves.
Right.
And I had to throw that out the window a long time ago. I had to sort of understand that getting help wasn't a sign of weakness. We can't do this alone. We weren't intended to do this alone. You know, children were meant to be raised in a unit, in a community. And if one isn't there, I think we have to work really hard for our own sakes and for our kids' sake to recreate that little, you know, that little hui, I think is what they call it in Hawaii.
I like it.
My sister-in-law talks about
her
hui.
I need a hui.